they're in the water, and earlier in the day, whatever group leader that was calling out to the other humpback whales. And only humpback whales who know how to bubble net feed participate in bubble net feeding. And it's thought that it's only taught from a mother to a calf, if not from another adult whale that mentors another whale. So those are two different ideas of how it happens. But the humpback whales, if you've spotted them in the Atlantic water, you will not see them bubble net feeding. It's only something that humpback whales that come here to Southeast Alaska know how to participate in. And you've joined a very elite group of whale watchers today, because less than 5% of folks who come out to Juneau will have the opportunity to observe bubble net feeding, and you are now part of that group. So the way the bubble net feeding works, after the whales have come together and gone round for that dive, the group leader will go ahead and instruct the others to form a half circle formation, and then they will begin blowing bubbles from their nose. It's the air from their lungs. So their lungs are about the size of two Volkswagen Beetles, and they can fit a lot of air inside there. So they dive down deep, somewhere around 20 meters or so, and will begin releasing the air in that formation. And as that water comes up to the surface, the fish they're trying to trail, the herring-sized fish, we school together and are fearful of trying to go through the bubbles to escape being preyed upon. So whenever the group leader gives a signal, it is a deafening signal that kind of causes the clumping of those fish to come together. They will then begin rushing toward the surface, the humpback whales will, after the herring-sized fish that have begun to surface. So if you were out there, and I know I was today, I got to see a very clear shot of that herring and other schooling fish jumping straight out of the water toward the surface. That's why all those gulls we saw coming up or going down for a dive to get a quick and easy snack. So shortly after that, it was followed by the humpback whales, who were opening their mouth very, very wide, enough to fit up to 4,500 gallons of water and food inside that mouth. And they are a filtered feeding whale, which means that they can only eat very small things. And up here in Southeast Alaska, they are trying to eat a very large quantity of very small things. So their esophagus, the size of a grapefruit, can only swallow things about that large. If you think about a volleyball, it's a pretty close approximation as well.
Yeah. Too many fish, you see.